Hello, this is a simple demo, Java-based demo for Netflix Conductor. Before we go to the demo, let's see what service orchestration means. If in case we are having multiple services which have to work in sync to achieve something, there is a workflow which they have to abide by, wherein there is a flow, sequence of flow, there are some decisions which have to be taken so that an appropriate path in the workflow can be taken. So all those things can be designed very perfectly using Orchestrator. And one of the implementation of Orchestrator is this Netflix Conductor. So multiple services, we have a workflow which has to be followed. We will see the definition of workflow in a bit. And we leverage the service orchestration. So why Netflix Conductor is called so? So we know that in a orchestra there is a conductor, and the responsibility of conductor, yes, the responsibility of the conductor is the prime important responsibility, wherein it is managing the different music orchestra players in a way that it is asking them to play in a sequence, asking them to stop, play in a typical way. So all those things are being conducted by him. So basically he is orchestrating the whole the symphony. So if all these people are microservices, he is basically controlling how they work in sync to produce some symphony. And sometimes they have to stop and sometimes they have to start. All those things are being conducted by him. So let's see a typical workflow. So this is a workflow wherein we are trying to get the loan. So no need to get the details of what it is, but basically workflow will be having a start. In this example, there is a start, then it tries to fetch the customer details from a service. And depending on the loan type, let's say the customer is applying for a business loan, education loan, property loan, there are different flows. And so on and so forth. No need to go into the details of what happens, but basically this is a workflow. And if we see right side, this is the execution path. So when we execute, Netflix Conductor gives a UI where we can see the execution path. We'll see it in a bit, but that's what it is indicating here. So decisions had to be taken here, and this is the right path, apt path. And we can appreciate that it gives the visibility, and we are able to see the flow of a particular execution using the UI. So again, let's say another example of a workflow could be a customer order. So customer places an order, he does payment, warehouse receives it, warehouse, if in case the warehouse has the particular item in inventory, it accepts, otherwise it fails here, and then so basically this is a typical workflow which is there. I'll not go to the detail, but this is a workflow. So if in case we are using orchestrator, if we have not designed the system properly, there may be a lot of problems which can happen when we have to speak to these different services, microservices. So this, if we are having this orchestration there, we are able to see the visualize the workflow properly, we are able to track the failures, we are able to do retries, we have good observability. There are multiple n number of benefits, and this is the way to go if in case we are using multiple services which are working towards achieving something. Okay, so there is another way also, just for completeness, let me say that there is another way also. There is orchestration which we are speaking about in this video, but there is another way which is called choreography. Choreography is basically wherein these services would be leveraging some kind of message queue, and then they send the message in the message queue, and this service is responsible for fetching the message. It is probably pulling the message from the message queue, pulling it there, and then sending again something on the message queue. This warehouse receives a message from the message queue. So that is primarily the other way which we can use. So two ways, this orchestration and choreography. Choreography does not have a central service which is responsible for orchestrating the service flow. So let's go to the demo now. So this is repository which I have created specifically for this demo. Let's see what is there inside this. So let me first of all get this repository. So I'll git clone. Okay, so this is the thing. And then what we have to do, there are some steps which are written here. You have to first clone this, okay? And after cloning this, you have to have this thing up on your machine. And please remember, this is when you do this Docker Compose up, there are different ways to do this Docker Compose up. And let me quickly show you this hyperlink. So there are different ways to do it. What we are doing is in-memory conductor server and Elasticsearch and UI. Okay, if you want to have this one, then you may have to, there are different, three different or four different ways they have given this. But for simplicity, we are going to use this one, which uses an in-memory conductor server. Now, having said that, let me go there. And I have already got the conductor downloaded on my machine, which we can see here. So then what I have to do is, I have to do this, the Docker Compose up. Okay, let me clear this and let me paste this. I see some issue, it has popped here. I'm not sure it will cause any problem, but let's see. Let's see if in case it causes some problem, I may have to clear this, but let's see what happens now. So I expect to see the UI, this is the UI, and I expect to see the server also here. So the server, basically these are the different RESTful APIs which are given to create your own workflow, and you can do it from the UI also. For the simplicity's sake, let's do it from the UI. So what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to create a workflow first. So I'll click on the new workflow definition. And what I'll do is I'll take the workflow from here. So source, main resource, templates, and the WF is the workflow. So if I copy this, so this workflow has been created. Now what I have to do is, whatever clone I had done, I have to open it in the IntelliJ. I have opened the Netflix, and so what is there in this one? So we have this main class, and again, like we can see, it's a Spring Boot application, and we have this task runner configurer which we have to configure, and these are the three workers which I have created. These workers can be independent, I mean they can be different microservices, but for simplicity I'm putting it in one service itself. But obviously when we are doing some production work, they shall be in different services. And so after doing this configuration, what we need to do is, we need to have whatever worker we have added here, the same worker should be present also. So that's where, I'm going to the template, not to the template. And these are the three workers which have been put there. So this is simply going to accept the task, and basically it's a task definition. It is going to add two numbers and give you the result. It is going to multiply by 2 and give the result. It is going to multiply by 5 and give the result. Okay, so we have, what we have done till now, we have added this workflow definition in the UI. And if in case we want to have these task related attributes defined, it shall be good to have these also defined in the UI. So how we can do that? Just copy this and again go to the UI. You can use the REST service which is available, or you can go to the definitions, you can go to task and just add it here and save. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to execute this workflow which we just created with the name simple workflow. And what is the workflow version? 1, because we just created first version. If I go to the main, just to show you that it expects some JSON body. So that's what I'm going to give it here. This is the JSON body. And let me quickly start this as well. Okay, so I go here now and I say start. And it says that it has started running. So if I click here, I will be able to see the execution. So I don't have any decision, but decisions are also very easy to put in the workflow definition. But basically in my workflow, what was there? If we see here, workflow is like this. There are three tasks. The output of one task goes to the second task. Output of this task goes here. That's basically what the workflow is. And we provided two numbers here. Input was 34. And the first thing what it did was it added them up. It came 57. The second one received it and multiplied by 2. Third one received the 114 and multiplied by 5. 570 is the thing. So that's what the demo is all about. The source code I'll place in the Git and share the Git in the description. We can appreciate that these different tasks which are there in this example, they are placed in one service, but they shall be different services, and there may be very, very complex flows with a lot of decisions to be taken. But all the documentation is there with you and you can go through that. Finally, just let me show you this. This you can leverage for creating this, and it gives you the very nice description and documentation also that what is the Maven dependency, how you have to create the worker, and how you have to configure them in your service. Okay, so this can be a good reference point. Hope you liked it. Thank you very much.